I purchased the 8GB M1 Mac Mini and experienced these issues. And promptly returned it. For the 16GB M1 Mac Mini. And as a video professional, these are my first impressions and some things that you need to know about. I'm Raphael and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And I always appreciate the early thumbs up because the new direction that Apple is going with their ARM processors is fantastic. But if you're considering the M1 Mac and you do some serious creative work for clients, there are some things that you need to consider before choosing between the 8GB or the 16GB. Or if you should wait for the next gen M1X processors. I do video content every day. I create videos for clients, brands, large businesses, small businesses, editing, motion graphics, 3D animations, you name it. So my needs are pretty hefty. And my plan was to wait for the next gen processors, to let Apple work out the bugs, for the software to be ported natively to Apple Silicon, as most Pro apps are still Intel optimized. But my wife's 2015 Mac Pro was due for an upgrade, and we decided to pick up the Mac Mini as a replacement for her. She has her own channel and she edits videos in Final Cut Pro. And it made for a great opportunity for me to just see it and test it myself. We picked up the 8GB base model, set it up from scratch, plugged in an external SSD, fired up Final Cut Pro, and instant issues. Footage flickering, slow or non-responsive playback, crashes, memory leaks, system running out of memory, and this was just having Final Cut open. At first, we thought the flickering could be a cable issue, so we switched from the HDMI to a Thunderbolt to a DisplayPort, and still the same issue. Then we thought it could be the monitor, so we tried three different brands. We finally narrowed it down to the XF AVC codec that the C200 uses, because that is our main video camera and that's the codec that we shoot in. And this flickering was happening with HD footage and no plugins or color correction applied. The 4K footage was even worse. We got the spinning beach ball and the system locked up just to play it back. So until that codec gets resolved, the workaround for now is to film it in 4K with the MP4 settings and not XF AVC, or to transcode it to ProRes so the footage will play back better. I'm not exactly sure why the XF AVC is causing this issue, but I do feel that it will get resolved over time, but right now, not really ideal. I did also make sure that all the Pro format codecs were updated and installed, but as of this recording, this is still an issue. Also, I did a test in DaVinci Resolve and Premiere Pro, and there were no issues, but my wife prefers to edit in Final Cut Pro. And this issue only arose when we were in better performance, not in better quality. But better quality presented another issue where we couldn't get smooth playback when titles or other effects were applied to the footage. Our EOS R footage played back beautifully, just like in all the examples we've seen online, smooth, no issues, just as advertised. The XF AVC codec caused a lot of the issues that we were having. So if you have a C200 and you're considering the M1 Mac for Pro work in the near future, just know that the other codecs may have similar issues until they are all resolved. For the crashes and the low system memory, this happened about every 30 minutes while we were editing the HD footage. I wasn't really able to figure this out and we returned the 8GB before Apple released the Big Sur and Final Cut update. But it mostly occurred when we were working with long clips that were over 60 gigs in size. And that size was almost the same that Final Cut was using in the system memory. So I'm not sure if Final Cut was trying to load the clip into memory and with only 8GB of RAM, it forced it into swap memory, which caused a lot of the issues. But since transitioning to the 16GB model, we have not encountered that issue once, though there's still a lot of random crashes in Final Cut Pro. And this is why I don't recommend the 8GB at all if you use Final Cut Pro or Photoshop. Your system needs at least 12 gigs to run those two apps and all the other system functions. Otherwise, it'll start to move the memory into the SSD via the swap memory, which means that the system is using the SSD like RAM and trying to move info from RAM to SSD a lot. And I know that the system can handle this, but it's meant to do this when needed, not as a default and maxed out all the time. There is a good reason that these are entry-level machines. The 8GB machine is really meant for the casual user. Zoom calls, web browsing, word processing, and light creative work, with the occasional ability to push the system. It may work for a while, but the swap memory will lead to issues at some point. There is no way to resolve that or expand with the unified memory. The 16GB RAM option is better suited for those that need the headroom to multitask a little bit better. But I personally would wait for an option with at least 32 gigs if you need to do this type of work day in and day out. You'll be happier in the long run. But if you use Final Cut and Photoshop every day and you have to have the M1 today, spend the extra $200 and get the 16 gigs of RAM. And ideally get the 512 SSD to go with it as well. If the system has to use swap memory, you'll have a lot more headroom when you need it. But as my first impressions, the M1 Mac Mini is a pretty solid little machine. The pros are that with the right footage and native apps, it does feel very snappy and creates a very positive experience. The rendering is definitely faster. It feels like a 2021 computer. So high marks for what Apple has done with this computer. And I'm really, really excited what they have in store with the higher end machines. The cons, on the other hand, are that it's still new and early and prone to bugs, memory leaks, and random crashes. So make sure that you have autosave set up on your Adobe apps. And the 8GB model is not really suited for constant pushing of the system, and that many codecs and apps still need time to work natively. Also, make sure that you get a hub because those ports fill up really fast. What are your thoughts on the M1 Mac? Is it a go or no go for you? Let me know if there's anything you'd like me to test with the M1 Mac Mini. As always, thanks for watching. Give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe. I'm Raphael. I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.